Hi guys. So today I want to talk about a book that I've finished recently. This isn't my usual type of book. You guys know I usually read sci-fi, fantasy, upbeat, fictional stuff. But that's not what the most recent book I did like at all. It's a true story, it's true crime, and it was a really hard one to read. It's because the story is that brutal. So I wonder how many of you guys have ever heard of a little girl. Well, she wasn't quite a little girl, she was almost my age. She was 16. A girl in America in the 60s called Sylvia Likens. There's been multiple film and book adaptions of her story, and this book is one of them. This is House of Evil, The Indiana Torture Slaying by John Dean. That's so weird in there. So, basically, this book talks about the brutality in that house when Sylvia was under the care of Gertrude Banaszewski and her kids. It tells you loads of details about what hell they put her through. The absolute nightmare. That was why it was so hard to read. Reading all these details, I had to keep it down. It's too much. Surely can't do this to one kid. They did. So it's about her murder, and the book also talks about the court case that followed and what happened to each person involved and the whole thing after the case finished. So this particular book, right, firstly, like I just told you, an American crime is advertisement. That's one of the film adaptions. I've seen that and I've seen The Girl Next Door. So I'll read back to you. Death came knocking. In the heart of Indianapolis in the mid-1960s, through a twist of fate and fortune, a pretty young girl came to live with 37-year-old mother and her 7 children. What began as a temporary childcare arrangement between Sylvia Likens' parents and Gertrude Banaszewski turned into a crime that would haunt cops, prosecutors and a community for decades to come. Behind closed doors. When police found Sylvia's emaciated body with a chilling message carved into her flesh, they knew that she had suffered tremendously before her death. Soon they would learn how many others, including some of Banaszewski's own children, participated in Sylvia's murder, and just how much torture had been inflicted in one house of evil. Yeah. And then this particular book has a few pages in the middle of it that have pictures, including one of, this is always what gets me most, because I had actually looked into what happened to her before I got this book, and this particular thing always gets to me most. When they carved into her, there's a picture. Yeah. So I do recommend that book, but be warned, it's brutal. And I definitely do not recommend it for children. In fact, if books had ratings like films do, I would say it's at least an 18. So yeah, well, be warned. If you're okay with gruesome stuff, if you like true crime, then yes, I recommend it. Just be warned. Bye, guys.